Hi, gute YouTube, I'm Max and today I want to do another Yu-Gi-Oh card opening plus a scaling experiment. What I want to find out today is the individual weights of commons, rares, super rares, ultra rares and secret rares. So I kind of had to open a set which has all of those cards in it and I went for LC2. It's a nice kind of old school pack and what I want to do after opening is I want to scale all the secret rares, the ultra rares, super rares, rares, and some of the commons, not all of them, because there are way more commons in those packs than cards of the other rarities, of course. So I just want to see if, of course, the holos are heavier than the rares and commons, but also if there are differences between secret, ultra, and super rares. So another good thing is I can start with the opening, and for all the people who are not interested in my pseudo TCG science stuff, yeah, they have the opening to watch. Oh, Heraklinos, Electrum, okay. Oh, cool, Sparkman alternate art. That's nice. I think I have two of Avian in alternate art, but not Sparkman. So that's a new one. And Ocean. The opening itself will be rather quick. Oh, nice, a Grandmaster, Venomenon as a super, Dark Fusion as an ultra rare. Oh, okay, and Great Shogun Sheen, that looks nice, as a secret. Third pack. More Six Sams, and of course hero stuff, because it's GX, so lots of heroes, like Evil Hero Dark Gaia. Mirrorgate, meh. Not a good one. Bestiary, There are definitely better super rares, secret rares, and ultra rares in this set, but today it's not about the pulls, it's about the experiment. Of course, getting some good pulls out of here would be appreciated. Is that? No, that's not a super rare, but Diamond Dude is a super rare. I like him. Kasha sucks. Oh, and the Ultimate Nightmare Yubel, that's a great one. Last pack. Also, I am not sleeving up the cards because the weights of sleeves may vary. Oh, Avian, hello. So that would kind of mess up the overall goal of the video. To scale differences between the rarities. Sapphire Pegasus is nice. Future Fusion is decent. Oh, and Destiny Draw looks cool. I will give it that. So, okay. Now for the scaling part. Let's do it like this. Okay, so going with the secret rares first. We have Destiny Draw, 177. Whoops. So that's the secret rares. Now for the ultras. Whoops, I should not toss them over here. There we go. So that's already lighter. Okay, so that's already interesting, that secret rares are way heavier than ultra rares. I didn't expect that for super rares. 171. So the supers look kind of the same weight as the ultras. Oh, this one is a little heavier. And now some of the rares. Oh, wait. Oh, so. And now you can see a big difference between rares and the holos. That's the whole reason you could scale older packs with non-guaranteed holos to find out the packs that actually contain some. And now just to get a little bit of a reference, common cards, oops, I just realized that you can't see what I'm writing, oops, so let's go over here. So that's it for the scaling part. As we can see, secret rares are the heaviest. The ultra rares and super rares are kind of similar. But they are definitely heavier than the rares, and rares and commons are quite similar in their weight too. So what this means is, of course, for the old packs that are searchable via scaling, that's kind of what the whole point of that is, or the whole reason, not the point. So rares and commons are lighter than the regular foils, and secret rares are even heavier than ultra rares and super rares by, yeah, quite some margin. It's like, secret rares are like 179.5 on average. And those are maybe around, 1.73, 1.72, and rares and commons are around, let's see, 1.72. So, of course, another thing that would be interesting to check is if the weights are the same for old packs, but opening packs until I have a decent number of secret rares for old sets with non-guaranteed ones is pretty tough. And they should also be out of the same box because the card weights and pack weights between different boxes vary. Yeah, that's something I can't do. But for those sets like Legendary Collection, Mega Packs and stuff, you can clearly see different rarities have different weights. And it's good that they are set up like they are, with secret rares, ultra rares, super rares, and rares in each pack. So there's no possibility of scaling out the higher rarities because there's a secret everywhere. Of course, on the other hand, yeah, it's not too special if you get secret rares out of those packs, and getting one that is not guaranteed is way more special. So yeah, both models of set building and rarity. What means Verteilung in English? Distribution. Yay, there we go. Of rarity distribution in the set. So guaranteed high rarity cards are nice because you get all shiny stuff, and it's harder to screw with single packs. But non-guaranteed high rarity cards are nice because of the experience of pulling them. So I hope that was an interesting video for you. If you enjoyed, let me know. If you didn't, let me know too, so I can change it maybe. And as always, stay safe. See you next time on Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! And thank you for watching. Goodbye.